Hey everybody, this is Evan Abrams, and today I'm going to show you how to sync motion typography to audio. Because as you know, motion typography that's not synced up to audio looks kind of like crap. No, I said crap. What do you mean I can't say crap on the internet? Well, f*** that shit. Let's just go do it. Now, before we can get into syncing up any typography, we have to get into how After Effects actually treats audio. The first complaint I've always heard about After Effects and audio is that people think that After Effects has removed the audio, or After Effects has gotten rid of it, or it's muting it, or whatever. Here's how you can tell if After Effects has correctly imported your audio. Select the layer, hit LL, that's L twice, and it'll pull up this interesting set of peaks and valleys, which you may recognize as an audio waveform. This will show you that After Effects has indeed recognized that you have given it a piece of audio to look at. Now, the reason you can't hear it when you press spacebar to preview is because spacebar is a preview without audio. It's just what it is. If you want to preview it with audio, you have to RAM preview it, and you have to make sure in your preview window, which is found by going window preview, and that's this thing, by making sure that this here looks like it does here with not muted audio. Then you RAM preview, it'll go through, it'll render, and then it'll crank along some sound with it. Or, another option, you can press the decimal point on the number pad, or a period, because it's over on the number pad, let's call it a decimal, conveniently located next to the zero, which is for RAM previews. So, hitting the period will just cause it to play only the audio. And the last, and perhaps most important to us, is the feature where you hold down Command on a Mac, or Control on a PC, and then scrub through by clicking and dragging on the timeline. Now, have a listen. Basically, what it does is it's going to play the sound at the point where the playhead is as you're dragging it. If you drag slowly, you'll hear slow audio. If you drag quickly, you'll hear fast audio. If you can drag at normal, you know, regular speed, then you'll hear audio at regular speed. For our purposes, this is probably the most interesting feature because it allows you to go in and very quickly figure out when sounds are starting, stopping, when words are starting and finishing. And when you look at the timeline here, that'll give you another indication, when your waveform is up, when animations need to be starting, stopping, finishing, all that good stuff. So, we've got our tools, and now we can actually get into the nitty-gritty part of syncing up audio and motion typography. So now you have the tools, let's use them. Take your audio that you've imported into your project, drag it onto New Composition. From here, you click on this little button over here, Composition settings, change them up to whatever frame size you want, frame rates, blah, 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 blah. All of that is not important. What is important is that you select your audio and hit LL and bring up its waveform. Now, go ahead and listen to the part of the track that you're interested in doing.
Hey everybody, this is Evan Abrams.
This is what we're going to work on. You do that by hitting period, like we've already said. Now, here's the method I use. I make all of my text new layers. Hit Command or Control T, bring up your text tool, click anywhere, start typing. Hit the return key or enter key over on the number pad to accept your text. We're just going to do this first sentence to show you how it goes. Now, you want to arrange these in the way you want them to finish. So let's work backwards. How do we want this whole thing to end? Hey everybody, this is Evan Abrams, alright? This isn't the most exciting thing, but we're just trying to prove a fucking point here. So, now, the next thing to do is to determine how you want them to animate on. How do you want everything to get here? So, let's go with something really basic. Select everything, go ahead 3 frames, 1, 2, 3, and then let's set a position keyframe for all of them by hitting P and then hitting their stopwatch. Go back to the beginning and just grab everything and just drag it off the frame. So everything's going to pop in just like that. Woo. Not very exciting yet, but you know, just stick with me here. Easy ease all your keyframes, and then it's time to sync it up to the points at which everything comes on. So let's go ahead, and this is the actual syncing up part. where you're going to go through, you're going to find where each sound or each word starts. So hey starts here. So you're on that frame, hit the square bracket, the open square bracket, and it'll shift the layer to be there. And then every starts around there. But body starts about there. And you can even see in here where the starts are, kind of, where it kind of peaks. Because when you start speaking, it peaks. So, let's continue. Oh, here we go. We got a TH. And then we got is. Oh, here comes Evan. Moving right along. Almost there. Doing good so far. And finally, Abrams. How does that look? Hey? Hey, everybody. This is Evan Abrams. Let's have a listen.
Hey, everybody. This is Evan Abrams.
Not too bad, actually. It's kind of coming together, actually, here.
Hey, everybody.
Oh, we might want to move body up a little bit because it sounds like it's happening too late. We don't see it soon enough. So those are the kinds of adjustments you're going to want to make as you RAM preview and look through. But in general, you always want the animation of the thing coming on to be starting as the word is starting, and to be finished before the word is done, so you can read it and hear it at the same time. But that was pretty simple. We just animated this whole nonsense really fast. It doesn't look very good. While I'm talking about this, I'm going to go ahead and gussy this up a little bit. One of the things you want to make sure of when you're doing motion typographies is that your text actually adds something to what you're saying. This text here that you're looking at certainly doesn't. And in fact, it's pretty boring. This is one of the most boring font choices. Certainly, the movement isn't very exciting. And though it is correctly synced up, it doesn't really add anything to what it's synced up to. Always try to plan out that you want to say more with the words than what the words are actually saying. The best typographies are generally the ones that sustain interest, that add something special, and that have been thought out and planned thoroughly. If it's just a random smattering of words, that's great, but what is that giving you that you didn't already have by reading it or just by listening to it? Always when you're making motion typography, consider what you're adding and consider what more the typography can do for you. For example, if you're doing a motion typography of the monologue from the movie Fight Club, maybe consider at the end have the camera pull back and reveal that all the text made a bar of soap. That's a thing. Or that it forms some kind of iconography from the film. And as the words come in, try to have the words mean something or have them somehow go along with what you're looking at. You know, obviously, I did a pretty bad job in the intro because I'm not even using words. But anyway, I hope that this helps you to make typography faster so that you can take your time away from the syncing up of audio to the waveform, which is cumbersome, and move more of your activities towards the creative side of stuff and making something pretty unique and taking that planning time and that thinking time to, you know, try new ideas and try new ways of animating things and just experiment with what you're making. I'm Evan Abrams. I will be very excited to see what people make of this. I am a big fan of motion typography myself. I do a bunch for people. If you want one done, I guess let me know, or just do this tutorial and then you can make one for yourself. So give it a go. Like I said, I want to see what you guys do, so respond to this thing or tweet at me or whatever. I'm on the Twitter and I'm on the Facebook, and just send me the stuff you make. I'd love to see the motion typographies you guys come up with, and yeah, I guess that's it. If you have any questions about this, any of the techniques and tools that I'm talking about, but you know, mostly this is a pretty boring thing. I'm Evan Abrams. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you around the internet.